Well, guys, as we're stuck in miles of traffic, would you look at that transtemp? My goodness. So, I had to drop Allie off at the airport a couple days ago, but on the way down to the airport, I don't think I've ever told you guys this story. So, on the way down to the airport, all of a sudden, got on the highway, transtemp went up to, what was it at? I was texting you the whole time. 101, it was like 199, 200 the entire way to the airport. Got there, let it cool off to like 160. As soon as I got right back on the highway again, right back up to 199, 200. And this is kind of like one of the first couple times that I've driven it after that. We have not changed the bypass valve on the side of the transmission, that block. But this thing is getting abnormally hot. My dually does not get anywhere near this hot. But anyway, we're just waiting to get back home. As you guys can see, we have picked up some 2020 Black Edition takeoff wheels from a fifth gen. I've been looking at these things for a little while. I think that they would look good on Allie's truck while we decide what we're going to do with wheels. So picked up a set of these yesterday. Just got them cleaned up with some Renegade products, but that is where we are started. We're gonna throw those on a little bit later today and should look a lot better than the factory wheels that are on her truck now. But anyway, welcome back, guys. Hopefully you guys had a great, hopefully you guys had a great weekend, spent some time with your family. Truly, truly thankful for a lot in life. Hopefully you guys are as well, especially thankful for you guys and all of your support here. For me, for Allie, for Wrenchworks, for the channel, everything. Truly do appreciate you guys. But anyway, jumping right in before we get to what we're going to be fixing on Allie's truck and trying to resolve our transmission temperature issues. 8 days left for the Wrenchworks Loaded Toolbox giveaway. And also today and Monday, Sunday and Monday, Cyber Monday, we are still throwing in 3 custom shop towels and some stickers in every single order. So make sure you guys get those orders in now. Make sure you get those entries in. Also, we are working on getting everybody's orders out ASAP. You will 100% get them in the next couple days. We were waiting on some oil caps. We were waiting on some knives. So if you guys have those two items in your cart or orders, we're getting them out as soon as possible. But anyway, every single order through the giveaway, and this is important. This is why I'm trying to stress a couple key points here. If you guys order anything through the giveaway, through the next 8 days, you will 100% get it for Christmas. Everything that's online and is available is in stock and ready to go out, and you will get them very, very quickly. So don't worry, you're gonna get everything. You're gonna have it in time to put it under the tree for your loved ones, for yourself, whatever. Also, real quick, I've been seeing a couple comments, probably all positive actually. But for those of you guys who have never ordered anything from me, from Allie, from Wrenchworks, know deep down, and I know there's a lot of people out there, and a lot of you guys have, if you watch other people, you know a lot of other people sell merchandise, stuff like that. What I refuse to do, and again, I know a lot of you guys will back me up in the comments here, if you have bought anything from us, we use high quality stuff. That's why the jackets, the flannels, we try to keep prices as best as possible can. I don't charge $40 for a t-shirt, even though we use the same high quality stuff that everybody else uses. But the jackets and the sweatshirts and flannels, I am truly, truly proud of that we offer. You know, they aren't Hanes, they aren't Gildan. These are thick, heavy-duty jackets, flannels. I know you guys will love them. I would never want to sell anything that I would not personally wear. So again, the jackets are extremely heavy-duty. Look in the comments down below. I know everyone will agree with me. Oh, the tire's gonna roll away. These jackets are thick, they're heavy-duty, they're not cheap. Same with the sweatshirts. We use a high-quality sweatshirt. Anyway, I'm gonna stop with just plugging that, but know if you guys are on the fence about ordering anything, it is the highest quality stuff, and that's something that I hold really, really important. It's just a standard. I'm not gonna sell cheap stuff, period. I don't want to. But anyway, make sure you guys grab those entries, get those orders in the next couple days. We'll get you the free stuff, and then only 8 days left pretty much in the last week. Again, we are giving this away to one lucky person, and I will be calling you myself, and you will be getting this toolbox full of tools right before Christmas. You can come here, I can come there, we can hang out. It's gonna be an awesome time. But anyway, let's jump into today's video. If you guys saw in the beginning of the video, we're having some transmission temperature issues with Allie's truck. All of a sudden, it wasn't doing it before when we first picked it up. These last couple trips, the transmission temperature is getting extremely hot. Now, what I am hoping, fingers crossed, because this is still a factory piece that does fail and does have issues on, I believe it's the 13 and up trucks. I don't think the 10s and 12s have this part on the truck, but right down here, passenger side of the truck, gonna crawl underneath here, start looking underneath where your transmission pan is, right there. This little block right here, that silver piece, what that silver piece is a, I guess you would call it like a thermostat. It's not a, we are bypassing it. The part that we're putting on is a bypass. Now, there's a valve in there, and it's really for cold weather climates. What that valve in there does is heat the transmission fluid up faster in the winter time, gets it up to temperature, and then when the temperature gets up to, I don't know when it's supposed to open, but then it's supposed to open and then circulate through the whole system. Now, those valves, just like any other valve, can get stuck. So what I am hoping, and I'm not sure when we take it down if we'll be able to see anything inside there, but what I'm hoping is that the valve is stuck and it's not allowing the transmission to cool properly. So we need to probably pull the pan down. That's probably on my list, to pull the pan, change the fluid, and also change the filter after the transmission fluid has gotten that hot. We really didn't have an option. I was a little, I don't even know what the word you describe it as, but we were driving to the airport. We were already late to get Allie to the airport. I would have turned around and grabbed another truck, but we really didn't have time. She was going to be late, so I'd had no choice but to drive an hour to Nashville to the airport with the temperature and the trans being 199, 200, and then the same thing an hour back. Now, me and Michael took it out the other day, and it went up to 190, but that was really only for a brief couple minutes. So, not the entirely end of the world, but definitely not great. I did pull the dipstick. The transmission fluid is still bright. It's still red. It does still, it smells a little bit not perfect. So we're gonna drop that eventually, but I wanna make sure before we go ahead and do that, that the bypass block is actually going to fix our problem. Here is our aftermarket piece, and what you can see with this is there is no valve in this thing. This is completely straight, wide open, no restrictions, and this will basically allow the transmission to do its thing, flow. This piece is from RevMax. There's a ton of other companies that make these factory style connections right here. This just threads in. It's a very easy kind of bolt in, bolt out. This just kind of clicks in. We got to tighten these O-ring fittings up, but other than that, like I said, this is a cold weather kind of assistance. Now, if you are in a climate that's super, super cold. I'm not actually sure of this, but I believe Mishimoto makes one with a valve still in it. I'm not exactly sure. But again, if you guys are worried about your transmission fluid never coming up to temperature, if you're in that cold of a climate, may not be the thing for you. That's kind of your decision. But again, here it's mostly warm. My dually, like I mentioned, my dually has this already installed in it, has had it since we have our built transmission put in. And yesterday I drove to go get those wheels, about 5 hours, flying there, flying back, you know, the transmission, and it was about about 65 yesterday here. The transmission temperature never, ever, and I wasn't easy on it, never got above 138. So most of the time in the morning when I left, it was like 130, 135. It peaked at 138, ran cool the entire time I was driving it. And again, in the summertime, even when I'm towing, when it's really, really hot, stays extremely, extremely cool. So definitely a worthwhile part to put on your 13 to 18 automatic truck. So we're gonna go ahead and start installing this. Again, you really just loosen up some fittings, put it in, but I'll show you guys all that here in a second. Just like that, we have got this thing swapped out and installed. Very, very easy installation. Probably is gonna take you about 10 or 15 minutes. So on the bottom here, I'll try and hold this so you guys can see. It is straight through all the way on the bottom, but on the top here is where the valve is on this side, and it actually travels up and down right here. So without the light, you can't really see, but you can kind of see it just like so. Now this is in a closed position right now just because it was cold when we pulled it apart, so it's probably normally closed like that. How to test this thing, if it actually was working or not, I don't know. We could take it in the kitchen, put a pot of water on it and see if it opens up or not, but I'm sure Allie wouldn't be too fond of that, so we're not gonna do that. Anyway, right here, these clips are what hold on the right-hand side so you can see them a little bit better. These clips just kind of go around, snap in just like so. That is how those lines are held in on this side. And then on this side, it's a 20 millimeter sized open-ended wrench. It actually kind of works really nicely if you get a fits-all crescent wrench. Put it right here as you're tightening these up. That way it's a little bit more supported. But other than that, like I said, it is honestly probably about a 10, 15, 20 minute install, if that. Real easy install. We lost about a quart of transmission fluid, so we're gonna go ahead and fill that up. I didn't let it fully drain, and again, obviously you guys can see, you do not need to pull the pan or do anything. You don't lose an extreme amount of transmission fluid from the truck just doing that without anything else. So we've got some AMSOIL, of course, ATF that we're gonna put in this thing. Just should take one quart, and we'll back it out. Well, change the wheels and tires first, and then back it out. And we'll see if that was our problem. Fingers crossed. Hey, what are you guys doing? Hey, what are you doing? Whoa! Come on.
Stick your feet in.
You can do it. Grab my hand, little one. Oh, good job. Good job. Good job. Careful. Careful. Oh, slide on your butt. Okay, see ya.
That was fun. Good job.
You go again? Whoa!
Good job!
Good job!
Good job! Babe, we're working on your truck again. Awesome. You want to go see your new wheels? High five! High five, good job! Let's go look at mommy's wheels. Hey, don't pee on Bob. No peeing on Bob's tires over there. What do you think? Black wheels for life? No more silver or chrome? Hey, what do you think, Ray? I like them a lot. For factory wheels, I really like them. They're really easy to clean. That's important.
Yeah, I like them.
Yeah, it looks really good. People are gonna say we need to tint your windows. What you think, Ray?
Like I missed the
shop mechanic, back at it. Yep, lift's still here. All right, just making sure you guys aren't messing anything up in here.
Come here, kiddo.
That butt though. What? Why not? Oh, the joys of trying to take a picture of your child.
I almost ran over Minnie!
I'm not gonna lie, I'm really liking this look. It just looks like just a really clean factory look. I don't necessarily love the white letters, but on these you actually cannot get the white letters off. It's actually like in the tire, I believe. So we can always flip the tires around, or who knows? I'm not really sure. We're just having a little fun. I'm not sure what's gonna stay on the truck or not, but I do love seeing the truck all black. I feel like the camera is not really going to do it justice how clean it looks. These 2020 wheels, I don't know. These 2020 wheels, the only thing that's missing is the 2020 front clip. But who knows? But we definitely need to get the Laramie flares on here, tint the windows. All of that is coming. But I do really, really like these wheels on here. It definitely gives it a really, really clean look. When we get our lights back from Mad Dog Customs, that is going to take it to the next level and really kind of complete the murder look. So let me know what you guys think. Out of all the wheels and tires, so we've had the polished 14 wides, the polished, or I would say the factory 18s, and then the factory 2020 black wheels on there. I don't know. I think that's getting my vote. So again, I'm not really sure what we're gonna do with the 14 wides. I'm gonna hang on to them for now. I am going to sell the factory 18s with the brand new 275 7018 Cooper Discover AT3s. The little bit of miles that we have on these, we've actually put the most miles on the 14 wide. So I would say that the factory wheels and tires maybe have 50 miles on them, maybe. The fronts still even have, they have all of the factory nubs still on there. So those are pretty much brand new. I'm pretty much gonna try and what I paid for those, get for those. So if you guys are interested, just let me know. We can make it happen. But anyway, the only way to figure out if I actually fixed the transmission thing is to drive this thing a little bit. So we are just gonna go for a little drive and hopefully make sure this thing stays at 130, 140 max. If it does what the dually does, which it should, we should be in good shape. Otherwise, we have a much bigger problem. Well guys, I think we have got her fixed. We have been driving around for probably 35 minutes now. We have not seen above 125. You can see it's a little cooler today. So we drove about 20 minutes on the highway. Again, nothing crazy. We figured we might as well fill up while we're out driving around. I've got my AMSOIL all-in-one treatment ready, and we are just waiting for Mr. Gas Vehicle Owner to get out of the way of the diesel pump so we can actually get some fuel. Just pulled back into the driveway. I would say we've been driving at least an hour. 131. I would say that we have successfully fixed our transmission temperature problem. Like I said, I probably will still drop the pan, change the filters out, probably get some upgraded stuff. There is like an upgraded filter screw that changes from plastic to metal. I'll get that and probably switch the pan out to something else. But for now, I am finally happy. I'm happy with the look, and I'm also happy that we have no lights, no issues. I feel like we finally have a solid truck after all of the little things that we have had to deal with on this truck, but super pumped, very happy. Allie is kicking me out of her truck. She is she's trying to take some pictures of some of the Wrenchwork stuff. Apparently I'm not doing a good job of instructing her what looks good or not. I tell her she looks good. She looks everything looks good. Apparently that's not good enough. But anyway, guys, super excited. I love the way the truck looks. Like, I don't think the camera really does it justice on all of the black, but it looks awesome. super pumped. Hopefully you guys have a great rest of your weekend. Kick Monday off, kick some butt at work, get some stuff done. Super excited. We have a lot of great stuff coming up. They should be starting the new shop in about a week or less, so we still have quite a bit of work to do outside to get ready for that. But that is pretty much gonna wrap up this video. I'm glad that we do not have to put a transmission in her truck just yet, so crisis averted. But anyway, guys, that is it. Head over to wrenchworks.com. Make sure you guys grab all of your gear now. That way you get some free shop towels, some free stickers, get these entries in. We should be calling you guys in less than 2 weeks on whoever wins this baby. So get them in now, and I will see you guys in tomorrow's video. See ya. I just tell him you look good. You always look good. Can I park the truck now? Well, it's been sitting here idling for probably about 15-20 minutes. We are up to 150 just sitting here, which is still awesome.